Hello, Roseville Middle School. It is Mr. Bettin, and I hope all of you are healthy and safe as we continue to move through the school year. Definitely make sure you are checking in with your teachers on Schoology. But I wanted to take this opportunity. I wanted to read to you one of my favorite short stories that I was first introduced to in middle school. And there's a link to that short story at the top of this post, because I'm only going to read part of it to you with hopes that you click on that link and finish reading the short story yourself. So I'll hold up this printout of the cover of the short story. It's by a man named Richard Connell, and it's called The Most Dangerous Game. So enjoy as I read you this excerpt of The Most Dangerous Game. And when I'm done, click on that link that's included with this post to finish reading that story yourself. "Off there, to the right, somewhere, is a large island," said Whitney. "It's rather a mystery." "What island is it?" Rainsford asked. "The old charts call it Ship Trap Island," Whitney replied. "A suggestive name, isn't it? Sailors have a curious dread of the place. I don't know why. Some superstition." "Can't see it," remarked Rainsford, trying to peer through the dank tropical night that was palpable as it pressed its thick, warm blackness upon the yacht. "You've good eyes," said Whitney with a laugh. "And I've seen you pick off a moose moving in the brown fall bush at 400 yards. But even you can't see 4 miles or so through a moonless Caribbean night." "Nor 4 yards," admitted Rainsford. "Ugh! It's like a moist black velvet." "It will be light enough in Rio," promised Whitney. "We should make it in a few days. I hope the Jaguar guns have come from Purdy's. We should have some good hunting up the Amazon. Great sport hunting." "The best sport in the world," agreed Rainsford. "For the hunter," amended Whitney. "Not for the jaguar." "Don't talk rot, Whitney," said Rainsford. "You're a big game hunter, not a philosopher. Who cares how a jaguar feels?" "Perhaps the jaguar does," observed Whitney. "Bah! They've no understanding." "Even so, I rather think they understand one thing. Fear. The fear of pain and the fear of death." "Nonsense," laughed Rainsford. "This hot weather is making you soft, Whitney. Be a realist. The world is made up of two classes, the hunters and the huntees. Luckily, you and I are hunters. Do you think we've passed that island yet?" "I can't tell in the dark." "I hope so." "Why?" asked Rainsford. "The place has a reputation, a bad one." "Cannibals?" suggested Rainsford. "Hardly. Even cannibals wouldn't live in such a godforsaken place. But it's gotten into sailor lore somehow. Didn't you notice that the crew's nerves seemed a bit jumpy today?" "They were a bit strange, now that you mention it. Even Captain Nielsen." "Yes, even that tough-minded old Swede who'd go up to the devil himself and ask him for a light. Those fishy blue eyes held a look I have never seen there before. All I could get out of him was, 'This place has an evil name among seafaring men, sir.' Then he said to me, very gravely, 'Don't you feel anything?' As if the air about us was actually poisonous. Now, you mustn't laugh when I tell you this. I did feel something like a sudden chill. There was no breeze. The sea was flat as a plate glass window. We were drawing near the island then. What I felt was a mental chill, a sort of sudden dread." "Pure imagination," said Rainsford. "One superstitious sailor can taint the whole ship's company with his fear." "Maybe, but sometimes I think sailors have an extra sense that tells them when they are in danger. Sometimes I think evil is a tangible thing, the wavelengths, just as sound and light have. An evil place can, so to speak, broadcast vibrations of evil. Anyhow, I'm glad we're getting out of this zone. Well, I think I'll turn in now, Rainsford. I'm not sleepy," Rainsford said. I'm going to go smoke another pipe up on the afterdeck. Good night, then, Rainsford. See you at breakfast. Right. Good night, Whitney. There was no sound in the night as Rainsford sat there, but the muffled throb of the engine that drove the yacht swiftly through the darkness, and the swish and ripple of the wash of the propeller. Rainsford, reclining in a steamer chair, indolently puffed on his favorite briar. The sensuous drowsiness of the night came over him. It's so dark, he thought. I could sleep without closing my eyes. The night would be my eyelids. An abrupt sound startled him. Off to the right, he heard it, and his ears, expert in such matters, could not be mistaken. Again he heard the sound, and again, somewhere, off in the blackness, someone had fired a gun 3 times. So I'm going to stop there, Roseville Middle, and I'm going to encourage you to click on the link above to continue reading this story and find out what exactly is the most dangerous game. Have fun in your reading, take care, and don't forget to check in with your teachers on Schoology.